My name's Jackson. I'm on the adventure of a lifetime. I'm riding around the world on my motorbike and I'm video blogging as I go. Subscribe for updates and come with me on my travels. In the last episode, we had an unforgettable weekend in Pistoia. It's time for us to move on and we head for Florence. Santa Maria del Fiore is the cathedral in the heart of Florence. We stand inside and I try and imagine the authority that the building would have held hundreds of years ago. There's a few things we have to do in Florence. Waiting unnecessary lines to get into art galleries, eat a whole load of gelati and pizza, check out the Ponte Vecchio, and watch the sunset with the locals. The next day, we take a little day trip to a place south of Florence called San Gimignano. It's actually a walled village. It sits on top of this mountain, and originally it was a stopping point for Catholic pilgrims who were on their way to check out Rome and the Vatican. Our days in Italy are spent eating, drinking coffee, and people watching.
It's good coffee. It's really good.
After a few days in Florence, it's time for us to leave. Our next destination is Perugia, a couple of hundred k's away, but we plan on stopping through another medieval town on the way, Siena. On the way out of Florence, we have a few close calls. Italian driving can be reckless, and you have to be at the top of your game all the time. We head into the Piazza del Campo, the crown jewel of Siena. We do our normal thing, coffee, soaking up the warmth of the sun, and people watching. At least for now, we're happy just to absorb our surroundings. The novelty of new scenery is yet to wear off.
I think we might be lost. Come on, be around this corner.
We've lost the bike. I'm trying to find it.
There it is.
This afternoon we're headed to Perugia, which is about 100 k's away from here, and we're going to stay there the night. We're going to work out what we're going to do for my birthday.
Where we were on the bike for about 8 hours a day, and that was kind of exhausting. I'm just getting used to riding on the right hand side of the road now that I've been here for about a week. I've stopped making mistakes where I drive on the other side of the road. I can be an excessive planner at times, and especially when I was back home, I'd always be planning what was happening next. And at the moment, I think I'm spending more of each day just living in the moment, and it's kind of nice for a change. It's not very hard to live in the moment when you're in a place like this.
We spend a couple of days doing the necessities, washing clothes, washing the bike, editing video blogs, and catching up with family and friends on Skype.
It's my birthday today, I'm 28 years old, and got a lot of love on Facebook and from home this morning, so it was nice. And today we're headed to a place called Saturnia, and we're gonna go for a swim in this natural spring. So we have to find it first though.
It's good to have Nicole on the bike, and it's good to have someone to talk to and share everything with, and we have the headset so we can talk to each other, maybe a bit too much. And we're probably going to run out of things to talk about in a few more days.
pools look amazing, but the smell is an intense sulfur. You kind of get used to it. The heat makes up for it, but I think the smell is what keeps this place a little less touristy, and it's all Italians. So legend has it that these pools were formed by lightning bolts thrown down by the gods. Water pummels out at 800 liters a second, a constant 37.5 degrees. With an air temperature of 16 degrees, it doesn't take much convincing to spend hours soaking in the water. It's been highly recommended that we check out this place in the south called Matera. Unfortunately, it's over 600 k's away, and so we have to hop on the highway and eat tarmac for a whole day just to get there. The bike's quite comfortable and smooth riding when you're averaging 60 or 70 k's an hour, but a constant 130 k's per hour with wind pummeling against you for 6 hours really takes it out of you. We're getting used to people looking at us when we go through small towns. It's probably mostly the banana suit. You can't be so mean. I just can't see in between. You know what the sun's all about when the light's pretty. 600 k's on the bike today, a bit exhausted. And we're in Matera. And the whole place is stone, and it was used in The Passion of the Christ, if you've seen that movie.
From Asia, from Palestine, a lot of nun priests come here to escape from persecution, from other Christians, iconoclastic period, from Muslim, and they recover in this town because
salvation.
Because there are a lot of cave and you can eat them yourself, and the
they couldn't destroy the churches if they couldn't find them.
The guides told us we can get to this church just down there if we hike. They said we should get a guide, but I think we're going to try and do it ourselves with some water. Go down.
River and we find this 1,000-year-old church hidden behind some trees. I go inside and there's all these frescoes lining the ceiling that have slowly been worn away and vandalized over time. This Italian guy comes out of nowhere, dressed in full scout gear, and through a bit of mime and combining my Spanish and Nicole's French, we work out he's telling us that there's more cave churches on the top of the mountain.
Salite di qua, e c'è il sentiero, c'è la strada che va sopra.
So we hike up this mountain, getting lost along the way, and when we find the churches he's talking about, we run into the whole scout troop. They speak a bit of English and they invite us to walk around with them. Their scout leader turns out to be an expert on the area and tells us a lot of things we wouldn't have known, like how the pilgrims used to prostrate and lick the floor all the way along these tiles up to the altar.
This part a bit tombstone.
Yeah.
A little tomb. But there are a lot of tomb in the Neolithic period.
And that's from the Greek period.
See, Greek period. Fifth century before Christ.
A Neolithic
tomb. Seriously? That's the
Neolithic
period.
And
qua c'era un letto, a bed.
Ah.
Wow. A ship, cow, so the pastore, come si dice pastore?
The shepherd.
We say goodbye to the scouts who help us back across the river on their makeshift bridge.
Ciao.
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 That night we check out the pizza place that the scouts recommended to us and we head to bed early. We've got a big day the next day to get to the Cilentro Coast Road and we need some sleep. Next week we follow the coast back to Rome, stopping through Amalfi and driving on some of the hairiest roads in Italy.